Hello, scientific writers. In this video, we're going to talk about finding scientific literature that you need to cite when you're writing your scientific paper, or maybe that you need to understand your topic, or to get methods to do your own research. So we're going to look at two different ways of finding scientific literature: Google Scholar and Connected Papers. Hi, this is Brian from the Scientific Writing School YouTube channel. Let's get started by looking at Google Scholar. For the purposes of today's exercise, we're going to look at two ways of using it. One is to start with a known scientific paper and build out your reference library from there. The second way is to search with key words or specific terms that you want to learn about. Let's start with a specific paper. I'm going to start by pasting in the title of a paper that I published several years ago that is my most highly cited paper. For the purpose of this illustration, we'll pretend that I am a new researcher in this field and I've been given this paper by my advisor, or I found it in a search and it seems to be a foundational paper in the field. So I'm just going to enter the title and search. So this is the title, the authors, and the first few lines of the abstract. Now what I can do from there is look from that time, 2006, to now. What papers have cited that paper? And that's this cited by list, and it has 393 citations. So if I click on this cited by 393, it's going to show me all of the papers that have cited that paper. And so I can go through that and, you know, just read the titles and read the first three lines of the abstract, see if any of those grab me. If they do and I want to read them further, then I can click on the title and that will take me to the publisher's page, or if there's a PDF available, it will show up here to the right of the information. All right, so that is the cited by list. Let me step back. The other thing we can do is click on related articles. It's going to show articles that are citing the same articles that were in the reference list of that first paper. And so this returns 101 results. So by using these two methods, we can get a lot of expansion from our first source paper into a lot of other papers. And if you find some papers you like and you want to import them into your reference managing software, EndNote or Mendeley or Zotero or RefWorks or whatever you use, you can do that by clicking the star. So when you click the star, then you can save it to your My Library. And I don't have any lists right now, so I need to create a new and say done. I want to save this one also and put it in my reference manager. So I'll add that to the list, and this one, we'll add that to the list. And you can build that up and then go over here to My Library and look at the YS list and then export all of those in a BibTeX, EndNote, RefMan, or CSV format. Although it says EndNote, that EndNote format will go into a lot of other reference managing software too. So you can figure out which format you need for your particular software. That's how you use Google Scholar to start with one single paper and expand the literature search into a lot of different related papers. Now, let's say I don't know a specific paper. I just know a topic I want to study. I'm going to type some keywords here and I get 127,000 results. That's a ton of results, but I'm getting a lot of the same ones that I've started with before. So we can get to the same place. Say we consider this paper as a foundational paper, then I can start this process of looking at cited by and related articles. So the Google search is very powerful. How does it compare to connected papers? Let's go over there and do this same search. All right, so this is the entry page for connected papers, and it says to start, enter a paper identifier. Well, let's start with the title that we used before. So I'm going to paste that title in, and then I'm going to tell it to build a graph. Now, when I click build a graph, searched by title, so it finds the paper. I need to click it one more time, and then it builds this graph. Now, remember, in Google Scholar, you just got a long list of results that were in text. In connected papers, you're going to get a smaller list of results, and it's not in a list, really. It's in a a graphical representation of how these papers are related to each other. So let's look at how this graphic is built. In the center, we have a circle with a heavy line around it. That's our starting paper. What Connected Papers does is it searches through about 50,000 papers that are related to that one, and it returns the best couple dozen results. Now, what we can see is that there are different sizes of circles and different colors of circles, and they're all connected by these lines, but some of the lines are very faint and some of them are bold. And so all of that has information about the papers. The larger the circles, the more times that paper has been cited. So this largest circle here has been cited 595 times, whereas this smaller circle here has been cited 31 times. So the sizes are not directly proportional, but when you see a bigger circle, you know it's been cited more times. So that's a more influential paper in the field. Now let's say I click on this influential paper, and what I can see over here is the title, some of the authors, the source, how many times it has been cited, and how many references were in that paper. And then the abstract is right here. So in Google Scholar, we just saw the first few lines of the abstract, and to read the whole abstract, we had to click to another page. In Connected Papers, it's all right here. And I can hover over these circles, and you see on the right-hand side of the screen, when I hover over a different circle, it changes to the title, source, and abstract. So that's really great. If I click on one of these, then it's going to hold, and I can go over there and I can look at the connected papers for that publication, or I can link out to these other databases, Semantic Scholar, the Publishers page, Google Scholar, and PubMed. The color of the circles represents when it was published. So the lighter circles are the older papers, and the darker circles are the more recent papers. But notice that the results for this 2006 foundational paper only range from 2001 to 2013. Now, I know that this paper I started with has been cited since 2013. In fact, it's still being cited in 2021. So this is not a complete results set. Google Scholar had a much more complete set of results. Connected Papers is returning what they consider to be the best set of results, but it's not complete. So if I need the most recent papers, Connected Papers is not the best way to get there. Google Scholar would be better for that purpose. So let's say I want to dig deeper into this Schuler 2012 paper. So now I can go click on this Connected Papers logo, and it's going to draw a new graph for that publication. Sometimes it takes a little while, but here is the graph. The other thing with connected papers that you can't do, or at least I haven't found a way to do it, is to build up a list of papers that you want to get into your citation manager. You can't do that directly, but what you can do is go over here and click on Google Scholar. That will open up a new tab, and then you can click Save, add it to your list, and you've now got it on your list. As long as you're logged in to Google Scholar at the same time you're using Connected Papers, then that's an easy way to do it. Okay, let's summarize the pros and cons of each of these methods of finding and building out your literature database. So Google Scholar, you can directly build your citation list and export it to your reference managing software in Google Scholar. And it has a much more extensive search result. It's going to return all the results, not just the best couple dozen. So it's going to find a lot more sources. The drawback, in my mind, to Google Scholar is the text-based display, and then it's just a list, and you can only see part of the abstract. And so you have to do a lot more clicking and opening tabs or going forward and backward in your browser to see all of the results. And you have to scroll up and down quite a bit. So it's a bit more work to see the results, even though the results are more extensive. Now with Connected Papers, I love this graphical display. It contains so much contextual information about which papers are most closely related, how old they are, and how many times they've been cited. So you can really get a feel just with your eyes for how influential these other papers are in the field that you're trying to learn about. And I also like that it links to the major databases. However, the drawback is that you can't directly export your citation list to your reference managing software. You're going to have to go through either PubMed or Google Scholar to build that reference list out and export it. Now, that's not all that hard to do, so it's not a huge drawback, but it is something to keep in mind, in addition to the less extensive return of connected papers. So which one should you use? Well, use both. They both have different strengths. They both have their own limitations. They're both great. I think they're both really good sources. And you don't have to limit yourself to these two. You can also use Scopus. You can also use Web of Science. You can also use Semantic Scholar. They all have their strengths and their differences. When I'm finding scientific literature, when I'm writing a paper, I look at all of these databases that are available to me. Sometimes they're going to return the same results, but sometimes you'll find something different. And it's a process. You can't just sit down in one afternoon or one morning and build out your entire literature database. You need to keep trying and going through the process several times from different starting points. All right, I hope that was helpful. If you got value from this video, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to the Scientific Writing School YouTube channel if you would like to see more videos on scientific writing related topics. I'll see you next time, and happy writing.